Welcome to Jesse Waters Primetime. I'm Pete Hegseth. Now, if you make a mess, you can't expect someone else to clean it up for you.
Cold as coffee.
What the hell was that?
I'm terribly sorry.
Clean that up!
Oh, sure. Of course. Could you hold these just a second? Here you go. Don't worry about a thing. It's gonna be fine. There we go.
Gonna be fine. And Bud Light made a giant mess on aisle 9 when they tried to make this the face of their cans.
This month, I celebrated my day 365 of womanhood, and Bud Light sent me possibly the best gift ever, a can with my face on it. Check out my Instagram story to see how you can enjoy March Madness with Bud Light and maybe win some money, too. Love ya! Cheers! Go team! Whatever team you love, I love too. Okay. Love ya. Okay. Break a leg. Woo!
Playing a character. And now Bud Light's trying to clean it all up by trying to get back on our good side. Now, they claim no senior Budweiser Anheuser-Busch executive knew about the trans can, which actually makes it worse, because that means junior employees had no doubt that Bud's woke corporate culture would, of course, support celebrating 365 days of a man pretending to be a girl. So today, Budweiser put out an ad with a spliced-up compilation of a bunch of Clydesdales. You know, the old school Budweiser commercial, B-roll from the cutting room floor, when patriotism used to be their bread and butter. They're telling us Budweiser's still an American company, but they went woke, and now we should make sure they go broke. And it might be too late for a half-baked apology, if that's even what you can call it, because their customers are leaving in droves.
Chevy to the levee.
That's a lot of beer or water. This is just the start. Try finding someone at a country concert who will even touch a Bud Light. Bud Light's become so toxic that country star Riley Green just scrubbed the words Bud Light from his hit song, I Wish Grandpa Never Died. It's a great song. The crowd didn't mind it when he replaced the name with a competitor. It's a good time to be the silver bullet. Their mountains are shining bright blue because the iconic blue can of Bud Light has transitioned to bright pink. It's so bad that John Rich is telling his distributors to take it all back.
Bud Light has been the number one selling beer at my bar, Redneck Riviera, down in Nashville. And over the past 7 or 8 days, our Bud Light sales are non-existent to the point where we had to call the distributor and say, hey, would you come down and pick up these 118 cases of Bud Light, because nobody's ordering them and they're just going to go bad sitting here. So at the end of the day, if the customers don't want it, I can't stock it.
And if your distributors won't take it back, I hear Kid Rock will blast around into them for you.
Let me say something to all you and be as clear and concise as possible.
But don't worry, Bud Light. You may not have country music or flyover country chugging down your watery beer. But hey, at least you have Adam Schiff still drinking, of course, out of a bottle. And we hear the ladies of The View are still big fans.
I'm going to say this out loud. I'm a big Budweiser fan. When I drank, I liked my Budweiser, okay? So I have a lot of feeling about this. Bud Light's ad campaign with trans-influent Dylan McDermott.
Mulvaney,
sorry. Listen, Budweiser, we're all Americans here. We appreciate your beer, whether it's light or the regular beer. You have every right, and we have every right to buy it if we like it. Don't let them scare you.
Right.
Let us scare you.
Whoopi loves Bud Heavy. But if Whoopi and Pencil Neck's virtue signaling is all Bud Light has, it's not good business. Anheuser-Busch's values plummeted over $5 billion since Dillongate. Sales are already down over 10% year over year. That's all from backlash on one beer. But in many venues, Anheuser-Busch has a beer monopoly. You might call them Big Busch, kind of like Big Pharma. Just over the weekend, I went to Yankee Stadium with my wife and buddies Will Kane and Rob O'Neill. And there was nothing more satisfying than seeing fridges full of untouched Bud Light, normally the best seller. We all drank a local IPA beer instead. So did most everybody else. Now, I was going to make a big deal about this. I'm proud of our stand that we took. Until primetime producers told me the local beer we were drinking is actually owned by Anheuser-Busch. No wonder I feel a little funny today. Turns out they own a lot of beers, as you know. But that's okay. We may have lost this battle, but we can win the war against Big Busch. We have to hit them where it hurts the most. Bud Light. One target, no distractions. The ball is in our court. We may have mostly lost to woke Nike and the kneeling NFL when they gave a platform to left-wing causes that unnecessarily divide us. But those companies were really tough for people to quit. They made up our wardrobes and our Sundays. We tried and mostly failed. But Bud Light is just water that identifies as a beer. It's an easy switch. We can make the bright blue can synonymous with the Democrat blue and then crush it. And everyone will take notice as a result. That's why this really matters. It's not even about Bud Light. It's about sending a real signal, a targeted stand that we can actually sustain. A signal to all of corporate America that if you really go woke, you really can go broke. Companies need to return to respecting their customers and their country instead of mindlessly bowing to DEI consultants and left-wing activists. Now, I'm not expecting Bud Light will suddenly put Medal of Honor recipients or Rob O'Neill, the guy who shot Bin Laden, on their cans. They're not capable of that. All we're asking is for beer companies to just make beer and stay out of politics. It's not that hard. Do it with me. Blue can? Nope. Silver can. Or dealer's choice, whatever you want. Let's bring in Michael Seifert. He's the founder and CEO of Public Square, which is an app and website created in response to woke companies. It serves as a platform for Americans to shop businesses that support their core values. Michael, am I right on this? There have been a lot of calls for boycotts on certain things that are so broad and so big that ultimately their effect is diluted. Maybe a small blip, but not much. Is this a moment where it really did hit people in their psyche, the brand betrayed them, and something can actually be done?
Well, Pete, I certainly believe that this is a turning point in corporate America because your monologue was brilliant. This is so much bigger than just Bud Light. This is a message to the rest of corporate America that if you go woke, you will face the consequences of millions of patriotic Americans that have said, we're done. We've had enough. I'm tired of being lectured by the companies that I'm shopping from. I just want a good beer. So I think the most telling sign of the past few days that Anheuser-Busch has recognized they took a bet on wokeism and it failed is the fact that they released this Save Face ad trying to recover. And I think that ultimately for Budweiser, it's too little, too late. I know that there are lots of patriotic Americans like myself and my family and our friends that will never be picking up a Bud Light again. They're trying to recover without a full apology. But I hope this sends a loud and clear message that millions of Americans are ready for a non-politicized experience in the marketplace with classic American values at the forefront of our transactions.
Michael, is it your experience that Bud Light, Budweiser, Anheuser-Busch, they're in a box, right? They can't really apologize because if they did, it would be an affront to the DEI, CEI, corporate culture they've created where their employees would be outraged. How dare we apologize or do an about face?
Well, and what's interesting, Pete, you bring that up. Budweiser is now getting pushback from the left, who are saying that you didn't stand your ground enough. And the Whoopi Goldbergs of the world are frustrated with them that they didn't take a stand for transgenderism more. And so what's interesting is that Budweiser, by trying to play both sides of this, they've actually created a very difficult situation for themselves where no one is happy with them. John Rich's bar is not selling Bud Light. I walked through a grocery store today, and that was the only beer that was stacked all the way to the top of the aisles because people were done with it.
You're exactly right.
But now the left is mad at them, too. And so they have learned a hard lesson that I hope the Millers and the Coors and all these other companies will pay attention to, which is that you need to leave this type of stuff. Don't lecture people about gender when they're trying to drink your beer.
Michael, thanks for what you're doing to try to change it, and I appreciate that perspective. Let's hope this is a watershed moment. It's just beer, but it is so much more. Michael, thank you so much.
Thank you, Pete.
You got it.